Okay, guys, today we're going to go over a couple of bar drills that you can do in repetition so that you can still maintain some of your shaping that we need to continue to focus on without actually being on the equipment. I am using some equipment. Here it's minimal. Everything that we're doing, I'll give you something at home that you can use in place of the equipment that we are using. Mackenzie is going to help us out. We're going to start over here focusing on our tap swings. Okay, so we're going to start on our back. You have two foam rollers. If you don't have foam rollers, you can roll up two beach towels and use a beach towel underneath your legs and underneath your arms. We're going to focus on keeping our ears covered. The roller is underneath the calf of the leg and the top of the arm, the shoulder area. Make sure your head is not resting on the roller. You're going to lift up and open. Really push those hips open and down and up. We're going to do five of those. Down and three. Down, four. Down and five. And you're going to hold for one, two, three, four, five. Good. And then we're going to roll over to our stomach. Again, you have the top roller up underneath the, your upper arm, chicken wings, and the top of your shin. And we're going to do the same thing, making sure your ears are staying covered, really trying to create that rounded back shape, focusing on the tap shape positions for your giant. And up, one, down, up, two, down, three, down, four, down, five, and hold. Really round that back. We're holding for five. Each one of these stations you're going to do you're going to do three sets. So three sets of five on every single station. Okay. We're then going to come over to a floor bar. If you have a floor bar at home, that's awesome. If you have parallettes, you can put them together and make a floor bar. If you don't have a floor bar at home, you can use a tape line. Use a crack in the sidewalk. It doesn't really matter. As long as you've got a line that you're able to line your shoulders up with, that will work. So you're going to start with a slider. If you don't have a slider, you can use a paper plate. You can use a frisbee. You're going to have your shoulders over top. You're going to slide to your pike position and then slide back out to your rounded and down. And we're going to do that five times. Up, two, and down, and up, three, and down, and up, four, down, and up, five.
Oh, gosh.
Okay? So that's what we're going to do next. Your next thing is going to be the slide your feet into the pike position, and then I want you to press all the way up. If you're not able to fully press up to the handstand, just press as far as you can with your shoulders over top of the bar, lifting the toes up off of the floor and holding for at least 3 seconds. Okay, over here, we're going to come back over onto a wall. You're going to scoot your buns into the wall. Grab a dowel rod, a pull noodle. You can use a broom handle, whatever, something to simulate the bar in your hand. Right here, we're just going to work on that scooping position up over top of the bar on your giants. So you're going to lift, ears covered, and down. We're going to do this five times. Up, two, down, and three, down, four, down, and five, and hold for two, three, four, five, and down. Our next variation of this, those of you that are working in blinds and or swing halves, we're going to work on leading that turn with your hips. So you're going to lift up, and then turn, and then down, and up, turn, down. Again, we're doing five of those. There's three. And down, and up, and five. And we're going to hold, three, four, five, and down. Okay? Really focusing on keeping that head in and those ears covered the entire time. Focus on then we're going to do, we're going to come over to our BOSU ball. If you don't have a BOSU ball, one of your big couch cushions will work for this, just something so you're not on a totally stable base. I want you to be using those fingers like you would be on a bar. Right here, we're just going to be working on our shoulder shrug, which is going to be the first part of your shape that you need to use for going into a clear hip. So you're going to shrug up, one, and down, and two, and three, and four, and five, and hold for one, two, three, four, five. Okay? Again, three sets of everything that we're doing here. Back over to your line or floor bar or parallettes. Find an exercise ball. If you don't have an exercise ball, you can also do this off the end of your couch. The couch arm will work just fine. You're going to put the ball almost to your hips. Make sure that your shoulders are up over top of the bar. You're going to plant forward slightly, and then we're going to push back and round with ears covered into that nice push-out position as we swing down into our giant. We're going to do five of those. That's two. Stay nice and tight in your core, pushing up through the back. And last one. And round. Good. Okay. Last thing that we're going to do is we're going to do some handstand, wall handstand work. It doesn't matter if you start with your stomach or your back up against the wall. We're going to hit both sides because we're going to pirouette down the wall. I really want you to try and focus on staying in the proper shape as you move the hips and keeping the body in line as you turn your body from one side to the other in the pirouette. So you're pushing nice and tall, and you're going to make that first hand change, and then you're going to shrug through the shoulder and push to your back. And again, you're going to turn the hand, and you're going to push and shrug. Okay? Really pushing through that shoulder, nice tall body. Okay? That we're going to try and do with that. Y'all know Mackenzie's had some elbows. So this is a lot of arm work for her, so I appreciate everything that she's doing. Okay, the other thing that I want you to do, and I would like to see you all when you do these pirouettes, traveling pirouettes down the wall, I'd like to see you go both directions. Okay, so go down one way and then head back the other way. And again, it's down and back three sets. Down and back is one. If you look now, you can see Mackenzie is doing the blind change version of this. And you can do this by stopping in the quarter, on the quarter handstand, and then finishing the other quarter. Once you do the quarters, if you feel like you're able to do the full half, then absolutely do the full half. Really focusing on keeping those shoulders nice and tall and ears covered the entire time. Okay, guys, I hope that this helps get you all moving into some bar stuff, and I'll check in with you later. Bye.
No.